Teams has a brilliant app for approvals. Even today, many approvals happen on email, attachments, chat, and then we have to follow up. If there is a dispute, it's difficult to know exactly what happened when. All those problems are solved when you use Teams approvals app. So let's learn how to use approvals. First, we have to install the app. The main menu of Teams is on the left side. Click on the three dots and search for approvals. When you click on it, it gets installed, and now you will see it on the left side. If you're going to use it very often, it's a good idea to right-click and pin it so that it doesn't go away. In fact, some things which you may not be using here, for example, files, you can unpin as well. When the main approvals menu comes, there itself, you have some benefit immediately visible. And I actually get a list of all the approvals I have requested in the past and their history. I can export it to a CSV as well. The export is limited to date range in 90 days within a year from today. The CSV gets saved in your OneDrive and you can open it in Excel to do further analysis. I'm going to start simple. Start a new approval request. We have basic request, which is very simple, or you have multiple templates. Let's start with basic request. So let's say, and now I want approvers and I want responses in the assigned order. In this case, I'm going to put only one person's name, but if there were multiple, it will send it to them in that order. So I'm going to send it to my boss. Priority you can set and additional details. If required, you can also add attachments. I'm going to click on send. So let's look at it from boss's point of view now. My boss seems to be using the dark mode in Teams. How will boss know that some request has come in? Boss will get a notification in the activity tab. I will get a request. And when I click on the request as boss, I will know all the details. It will also tell me at the time and date at which it was sent, what is requested, details. If there was an attachment, that would also be visible and openable here. And now I can put a comment and either approve or reject. I can even reassign it to someone else in case I feel I'm not the right person to do this. And I'm simply going to reject this. So let's see what the assistant sees. Of course, I get an activity notification. I see that it is rejected and all the details about the rejection are also shown here, including the timestamp. This can be saved as PDF if you want to keep it as a record for further reference or as an archive. Of course, boss can also see a list of all the requests boss has received and what has been the status, including the people who have requested it. This was a simple approval request, but now let's see how to create more complex and realistic templates. When you create a new template, yes, you can start from scratch, but Microsoft has given us lots of ready-to-use templates. I strongly suggest you go through all of them because I'm sure you will find some of them immediately usable. These are in different categories. We have activity-related templates, administrative templates, finance-related, attendance, and order management. I'm going to start with a simple business card template and I'll show you how to customize the template. I'm going to say new template and choose business card. Click on next. Choose a theme where we can add it. And now you can customize the template. It is done in three steps. The basic settings is just the name, category, and description. In the next step, we design the form. Each item in the form can be text box or different types of elements like choice, text, and date picker. It's almost like MS Forms with a limited set of controls. You can have mandatory, short or long answers, subtitle, and some restrictions like numbers. And then in the next step, there are workflow settings, means how is this approval going to proceed? We can decide whether you want an attachment or not. If it is not relevant, do not force people to put attachments. Approver options are important. Require responses in assigned order. Means what? In the earlier example, we had only one approver. If there were multiple, it's asking you, should it go in the order in which you have added them, or they can approve or reject in any order. The other important thing to understand is who is going to decide the approvers. Now, of course, there is no hard and fast rule. It depends on the situation. If usually you are doing it in such a way that the requester decides the approvers, keep it as this option. If it is predefined based on business policies, then you can use the other option where you specify approvers at template level. Custom responses just allows you to change the text, approve, reject, yes, no, or something like that. I would say, yes, it is optional, but it's a good idea to keep comments because the approver would like to put their comments or some additional information. In case they reject, they would want to say why they rejected. So comments being on is a good idea. Once this is done, you can look at the preview and then publish it. Once it is published, it's available. Where is it available? Well, I already showed you. When we go to approvals and then say new request, basic request, and then you see the published templates here. So that's how approval is a built-in, easy to use, immediately actionable application, which I'm sure you would want to start using immediately. The only way to do that is to teach this and show that it is useful to your team, your bosses, and your organization. In fact, Teams has many useful features. I have a very popular video about Teams best practices. I strongly recommend you have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.